harvest on for us. Mark chapter 16. I'll finish it quickly. Mark 16, 1 to 9. I would like as you all stand and we read that text all together. Woo, we roll the stone. Jesus rolled the stone of this young lady. She just walked, and the anchor was very happy because of that healing on Sunday. That took place on Sunday here in Miliman. Healing is taking place. People are being healed. If you are the one waiting, that's your problem. But healing is our portion. Can we read together chapter 1 to 8? That's the story of the resurrection of Jesus. Let's go together. It's projected for us. Whichever version you have, read it. Verse 1 to 8. Let's go together. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't be afraid," he said. "You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciple and Peter, he is gone ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you." Trembling and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. Let's give a hand clap to the Lord. What a good story. A good story. Be seated in the presence of the Lord. The great story of the resurrection of Jesus. I like the way Mark has put it. Who will roll the stone? Who is going to roll that stone? That was a big question for the women before reaching the tomb. But by the time they reached there, the stone had been already rolled. The power of the resurrection rolled that stone. When they reached there, the stone was no longer there. And I like the angel said, "Why are you looking for the one who is not here? He is not here. He is risen." That is the difference between our God and other God. Jesus is risen. Muhammad is still in the tomb. All other gods or leaders or gurus who said they were great guys, they did not rise from there. They're dead. In fact, they are called late. You can hear late Mandela, late so-and-so. But Jesus is not a late. He is alive. He is alive. He is alive. He is not in a grave. And because of the resurrection of Jesus, there are five things I can say that happened. One, because of the resurrection of Jesus, death will never have any dominion over Jesus. Death has no dominion, had no dominion at all on Jesus. He conquered death. Can I hear amen for that? Romans chapter 6 verse 9 says, "We know that the Christ being raised from the dead will never die again." Death. no longer has dominion over him. Death had a dominion over Muhammad, but not on Jesus. He is alive. Can I hear amen for that? God raised him from the dead, no more to return to corruption. The resurrection of Jesus bring us a guarantee that we will raise. Can I hear amen for that? When we bury our dear one, yesterday we were in Siaya to do the burial of the brother to our Deacon Morris. We did the burial. But the good news in the message of Easter is that death has no power on Jesus and on those who are following him. Can I hear amen for that? Death has no power over us. We will live beyond the grave. There is hope beyond the grave. That's our point number one. Because of the resurrection of Jesus, death has no dominion over us. Jesus' resurrection is the beginning and a guarantee to our resurrection. If he rose from the grave, we too will rise. Thank you. Number two, because of the resurrection of Jesus, we are born again to a living hope. There is hope for a believer. Can I hear amen for that? Because of the resurrection of Christ, we are not hopeless failure. No. We have hope beyond death, beyond grave. We have hope. Our hope is built on nothing less except in Jesus. On solid rock, that is our hope. I am not a hopeless man. I'm hopeful because of the resurrection of Christ. There is hope for you. Tell your neighbor you have a hope in Jesus. Tell it again with the joy. You have hope beyond death. Amen. 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 Because of the resurrection of Jesus, we are born again to a living hope. 1 Peter 1:3 said, blessed be to the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to his great mercy, he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Is hope for a believer. We are hopeful people because of Christ. Our life is not just finished the way the life of a cockroach is finished. Cockroach you can kill with doom. We are not cockroach. We are not animals. Our lives are hidden in Jesus Christ. That's hope for us as a believer. Point three, because of the resurrection of Jesus, God has given Jesus the name above every other names. Can I hear amen for that? That's my point. I like that point. Philippians 2:9-10 says, God has highly exalted Jesus and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. Can I hear amen for that? Jesus has been given name above all other names, in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. God exalted him above all other names. At his name, every knee shall bow. Evil must bow. Sin must bow. Sickness must bow at the feet of Jesus. Muhammad must bow. Terrorists must bow. Al-Shabaab must bow at the feet of Jesus. God has given him a name above all other names. Name them above cancer, above tumor, above tuberculosis. God gave Jesus' name above HIV/AIDS. His name is above all other names. His name has power to heal. That's my last point. He has the power. Every knee shall bow and confess that he is the Lord. He's the Lord over all. He's the Lord over witch doctors. He is the Lord of what is happening in Loliandi, Loliondo. His name is above what is happening in Malakisi. This young lady went to Malakisi, was not helped. She said, the story is wrong, Pastor. I don't know how to tell you. I went to Malakisi. I was given, they even cut my blood. They drank my blood. We said, don't ever go there. The name of Jesus is a strong tower. There is a healing in the name of Jesus. He is healing even now. Jesus can heal you right now. You can walk. You can live. He conquered death. Amen. Can I hear amen? I don't know what situation you are going through that has been threatening your life. You've been so discouraged. I have come here to tell you there is a good news for you. God, through Jesus, can heal you. You can be healed in the name of Jesus. If this lady, Sheila, walked, I was even amazed to see this young girl who came from Sundu with a scratch going to the car without that scratch. That's a miracle God can do even today. May God do that miracle today in your life. I don't know what situation you are going through. Maybe you are saying, I have reached the end of my road. You have started the beginning of your road in the name of Jesus. May God sustain your life. His name is above all other names. Doesn't matter, maybe you went to see the doctor and say your condition is impossible. I have come to tell you, with human being it could be impossible, but with God all things are possible. That is the power of the resurrection of Jesus. Healing is possible. Success is possible. Salvation is possible. Forgiveness of your sin is possible. Restoration is possible. What the enemy has stolen from you can be restored back to you through the resurrection power of Jesus. This power is at work. Is at work now. Is at work today. It has worked in your home. God gave him a name above all names. I am just pitching my tent there. And every name in heaven, every name on earth, every name underground, every name underwater, that means water spirit has no power over your life. Can I hear a big amen for that? The spirit of sickness and disease has no power over you. The spirit of death has no power over you. You shall not die. Because of the resurrection of Christ, you will live. That is the power of the resurrection of Christ to put us in a high pedestal through Christ Jesus. And I like when Jesus was going, he told his disciples, I give you the key of the kingdom. I give you the key of kingdom. I have given you the key of kingdom. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you lose on earth is loose in heaven. Whatever you dismantle down is dismantled up there. That is the power of the resurrection. When you say no, it is no. When you refuse something over your life, you have refused it in the name of Jesus. It shall not take place because of the power of the resurrection of Christ. Can I hear amen for that? Can I hear amen for that? For those who are sick, I have a good news for you. Healing is your portion. That's my last point. Healing is your portion. Because of your resurrection of Jesus, your healing is guaranteed. The little girl gave us here the message, by the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. He bore all our sins. He bore by his wound, we are healed. You too are healed. There is a guarantee of healing. The power of healing is at work. He heals even now. What else can we follow? If Jesus can heal, if Jesus can forgive, if Jesus can give salvation, what other name should we follow? There is no other one. His power is available right today. By his resurrection, you can appropriate that victory. That victory is yours. The power that raised Jesus from the grave is the same power we are using in Sitam Kisumu now. He rose Jesus, he will also raise you. God can move your stone as well. What stone is hindering you to access your destiny? What stone is hindering you to move to your next level? I don't know, what is that stone affecting your health? What is that stone affecting your family? What is that stone making you so sad in your office, in your marriage, in your spiritual life? What is that stone attacking you? You cannot break that addiction. The power that rolled the stone is available. It's available. It's available. It's available. It's available. It doesn't matter how long that stone has hindered you. I have come to tell you today, that stone must be rolled away. May it be rolled away. From your health, from your family, from your body, from your business. The power that rolled the stone, that stone can be rolled even today, is in this house through Jesus Christ. Through Jesus Christ. Can I hear a big amen? Maybe people have bewitched you. They've worked things on you. They've taken your name, they've put under the water. They've written your name, you will not prosper. You will not succeed. You will die prematurely. I have a good news for you. You shall not die. You shall not die. You shall not die. I hear amen here. I don't know what about behind there. You shall not die. I hear it. I hear. You shall not die. You shall live because of the resurrection power of Jesus. It doesn't matter what the devil has done. It doesn't matter how long he has worked on you. You can work on him reverse gear now. Today is the day of reversing. We want to reverse all. We want to roll the stone all. Stones can be rolled away. May your stone be rolled away today. I don't know what that stone has been blocking. But today, as we celebrate Easter, may that stone be rolled away. Be rolled away. Be rolled away. If it's a stone of sickness, may that sickness be rolled away. Is it an asthmatic attack? It must be rolled away today. Is it HIV AIDS? It must be rolled away. Is it addiction? You cannot break drinking or smoking. We break that in the name of Jesus and lose you free. What else can we say? Is it the place of your job? You cannot make it. You've been sacked all from January. You are still being sacked. Now you are the one to reverse the gate. We reverse that stone in the name of Jesus. We reverse that stone. May that stone go to the name of Jesus. That's the power of the resurrection of Christ. Is it you want to be married and no one is coming? I want to roll that stone out today. I want to roll it away. There is less amen. You know, this is a prophetic service. I am not joking. I'm dealing with head collision here. I'm talking to your destiny. I'm rolling that stone once and for all. That stone blocking your marriage must go away. That stone blocking your child to come must go away. That stone blocking you not to get a job must go away. We are rolling them away today. Roll them away. Roll them away. Roll them away. That's the power of the resurrection of Jesus. It's available for you. For you. For you up there. Even in your academic, if you've been failing, I have come today to declare you shall not fail. I am rolling that stone of failure out of your life. Delaying of marriage out of your life. Backsliding out of your way. That stone must be rolled away. Hallelujah. 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 That is the story of Easter. That's the story of Easter. Jesus kept his promise. He will keep his promise. What he said he will do, he will do it. He will fulfill it. He will heal. He will save. He will change that impossibility to possibility. That is the story of Christ.